Can we just give this woman like the keys to the world? Is that a thing? Is that a thing? You know, they have like keys to the city. Do they have keys to the world? And if so, can we give them to Taylor, please? I feel like at this point, we might as well. You know, I mean, flipping it. If people like Donald Trump can be president, then surely Taylor Swift can be like goddess of the world or whatever. Goddess of Earth. That can be her official title. I'd be fine with that. Hello, my wonderful royals, and welcome to my YouTube channel, Brie K-Pop Reacts. Today, we are doing the glorious, the wonderful, the goddess that is Taylor Swift once again on the channel. I am finally here to react to the Midnight content, which I've been waiting to do since it dropped. It has been out for a little bit now, I realise this. I have been waiting for the opportunity to sit down and properly do this. I wanted to kind of chunk it into, you know, one bubble, if you will, because obviously I wanted to react to the MVs that she's dropped. I also wanted to react to the album, and obviously the album reaction is naturally going to be pretty big, so I thought I want a situation where I can kind of do them all pretty soon after each other, so I'm not waiting ages between them. So I am sat here now ready to react to this content. I am planning to do obviously the MV, both the MVs in this reaction that you're watching right now. I am also planning to do at least the first half of my album reaction today. I am planning to split the album into two parts because it's quite a big album, but I am planning to record at least part one of that reaction today as well. So it's going to be a Taylor Swift focused day, and I'm hugely excited about that because I'm really ready to check out this album today. The more I've thought about it, the more I've thought as it's been gearing up to this day, I've just been getting more and more hyped for this. I genuinely can't wait to check this thing out. For those of you that haven't seen my Taylor Swift content before, I'm a Swiftie, of course, as you can tell from the backdrop and the wall and the albums and the name of the channel. It is generally a K-pop channel. It is K-pop content I most of the time do, but I do like to dive into other content as well. Obviously, I'm interested in other types of music, and Taylor Swift is one of those artists that I've been into for a long time. I've been a Swiftie for a long time, even before I even knew that K-pop was a thing. So I am a huge fan of this wonderful lady. There are reactions to her on the channel. I went through a whole journey at one stage where I was going through right from the start, doing like all the music videos that she's ever dropped, because some of them I haven't seen, and like doing album reactions and stuff for all her albums. I did stall on that. I will admit I did stall on that at one point. I got distracted into other things and never came back to it. Maybe this will be the Kickstarter for me getting back into that journey, because I was really enjoying it. But then I think I got up to like the Speak Now era, maybe. I think I got up to. So yeah, that's all there for you guys to watch. If you want to catch up on that, I also have reactions to Folklore, which that era was the first kind of reactions I did on the channel to Taylor Swift. So that reaction is still up. The Evermore reaction, I did do a reaction to Evermore when that dropped. However, that did get blocked. I do want to address that right now, in fact, because there have been people that have commented. I apologise if I've not responded to that, but there are people that have commented at various points asking about my Evermore reaction. It is blocked, and that's why it's not available anymore. I did do an Evermore reaction. It got blocked, which is very frustrating because I really enjoy that reaction. I have been trying to kind of get it released, but there's not really a way of doing it because it's an audio block, which means the only way to get rid of that would be to get rid of the audio, which would obviously be a problem. So realistically, I can't really get rid of that. If I can find a way to get it out in some way, I'll try. But it does exist. It does exist. It's just, you know, YouTube have banished it out into the wilderness, unfortunately. But regardless, there are a ton of Taylor Swift reactions on the channel for you guys to check out if you've not already. So please do catch up on my Taylor Swift journey thus far. That would be awesome. And of course, guys, if you enjoyed this reaction, please drop us a like, drop us a comment, and of course, subscribe to my lovely self. Join the royal family, become a royal yourself. I will admit, I have been neglecting this lady for a while now. I've been focused on my K-pop and stuff like that, and that's kind of, you know, taken me over for the most part. And I do feel like I've neglected Taylor Swift for a while now. And that's not on. That's not on. It's not acceptable. And I'm planning to change that today. I'm hoping this album absolutely murders me and gets me right back into the Taylor Swift zone, if you will. So that's what I'm hoping for today. I'm ready for this. Obviously, like I say, we're doing Anti Hero and Bejeweled. I'm ready. So without further ado, we are just going to get straight into this thing because I can't possibly wait any longer for this wonderful album. Today it is Taylor Swift time. Let's do this. So this is the glorious Taylor Swift with Anti Hero, the official music video. Which is the first one she released out of the two, I believe, which is why we are doing it first. This is the one that has the whole scale controversy in it, isn't it? Like the scene with the scales, where like the scales come up with fat or whatever when she's standing on it, which was a whole controversy. And then I think weren't they talking about deleting that scene from the music video? Have they done that? Is that done now? I don't know. I'm sure we'll find out. I feel like at face value, like, I've not seen the scene, obviously, so I can't. But based on what I know about it, I don't really understand. I don't see it as an issue because I see it as her personal story. Like, it's her making a statement on her feelings at the time and her kind of self-consciousness of, you know, seeing herself as overweight and things like that. And how she was feeling about that at the time. So I don't necessarily see it as a problem in the sense that it's kind of anti-fat or anything like that. That's kind of my views on it based on, you know, obviously I've not seen it and stuff, so that's based on my knowledge of it at this point. But by all means, guys, let me know what you think of that in the comments. I'd love to hear your thoughts on that particular topic. But this is Anti-Hero. Let's do it. Taylor! Finally! Oh my God. It's about bloody time. Look at it. Oh. It's not what you want in your eggs. That's creepy. What's going on? Voice, oh, I love her voice. I like time. Look at the Taylor and Taylor. Multiple Taylors. Okay. It's like different eras of Taylor, different versions of her personality. Oh, no. Oh, no, she's wrecking it. She doesn't mean to, though. She doesn't mean to wreck it all. Oh. This song is gorgeous. This song is gorgeous, guys, already. Whoa, her voice just breaks me. It really does. Oh, whoa. The other Taylor's face when she, like, throws up on her is perfection. I love just the... Oh, we've got the scales. Is this the scale bit here? The meaning behind the lyrics and everything, this is part of why I'm really looking forward to checking out this album. And I know a lot of you guys have already checked it out, like it's old news to you at this point, but I haven't yet. And I'm really looking forward to it because of just the talk surrounding it and the meaning of it and everything. And the fact that she's talking about all these issues that she's had, you know, the whole thing about like 13 sleepless nights, isn't it? That, you know, this is kind of her thoughts when she's awake at night and things, when she's awake late and can't sleep. And, you know, so all her kind of worries and concerns and issues and things are coming to the surface and bothering her. And like they do at night, they do, you know, that happens to me. It happens to, I'm sure it happens to everyone, you know, where you're up at night and your brain can't stop going and everything seems worse at night. And just that whole concept just really grabs me. And I love the thought that Taylor's going to dive into that stuff and dive deep into that stuff, by all accounts, from what I've heard. And already you can hear it in the lyrics of this song, the meaning behind it, the stuff they're putting in the music video. I'm not great at interpreting this stuff, so there's probably a ton of stuff I'm missing, especially on a first time watch, but I still appreciate everything that we're seeing here and everything that we're hearing. It's just such power and meaning behind it all that really comes out. I love this kind of like retro aesthetic to everything they've got here. I don't know if it's meant to be that way, but it's got a very like retro feel to it. It's the aesthetics of like the rooms and stuff, the decor, things like that. Are we going to see the scale? Table to face. So they cut out the actual where it says fat. They cut that out, I'm assuming. No, come on, guys. Have a bit of class, Jesus. This guy. Should we know who that is? Should I know who that is? I feel like maybe.
Laughing up at us from hell. What? What does it say? It's the worst.
But who got the beach house?
It turned into a f***ing cat sanctuary.
What?
What about the rest of the assets? I flew all the way here from Ibiza!
To my children, I leave 13 cents.
No! wait, you guys. There's probably a secret encoded message that means something else.
Yeah, that's what mom would always do. P.S.
God, people
There's
are awesome.
There's no secret encoded message that means something else. Love, Taylor.
What is going on?
Great. Well, good job, Chad. You finally pushed it too far.
Oh, of course he's a Chad.
I think she's implying that you haven't hesitated to trade on mom's name.
Excuse me?
Do you not remember your book, Growing at Swift?
And your stupid podcast, Life Comes at You Swiftly, which I'm pretty sure you're recording for on your phone right now. Chad, come on!
Chad. Flipping it.
That you name drop mom to get into, Preston. And Kimber, you're literally wearing her clothes right now.
No, I'm not.
That's from Fearless Tour 2009.
I was going to say, is that an outfit
you know
we should
we
know?
We were very, very close.
So I feel like the proper hardcore Swifties will get a lot of these references that I won't. Like, we'll see that dress and go, oh, I know that dress. It's from the such and such event of 2009. I'm guessing some of you guys are on it with that kind of stuff. I'm not at all. I'm guessing there's more meaning to this scene than meets the eye as well. For anyone that's in the know about all this.
Okay, well, you know what? We were very, very close. I miss her.
We were so close.
Okay, I'm just gonna say it. I think she killed her. You've gone too far! Kimber was the last
yes,
one with
Chad.
Her!
Yes,
she
Chad.
Didn't fall off the balcony! She was pushed!
This is brilliant. She sees herself as the problem. It's not. It's all the others. I love this like synthy sound we've got going on. Another one. That was Giant Taylor. Now the Taylor's all meeting up. Like a little bottle. Oh, she can't help but hit every time. Every time this woman just hits with everything she does. That's part of what I absolutely adore about this woman is that she's just so good at everything. Like, she's just so good at everything. Like, the writing, everything she puts into her music, her singing, the way she puts her MVs together. I don't know, how much say she has in the MVs and things like that, the music videos. how much say she has in what goes on with the music video. Let me know if you know how involved she is in that side of things. But everything she does is just perfect. It really, she just can't, she cannot do any wrong. And it's no wonder that she's taken over the world. It's not no wonder that, you know, every time she comes out with an album, it's a global event. Like, it's a huge, major deal. The fact that she's got the entire top 10 in, like, what is it, the, what charts is it? What charts is it? Billboard, iTunes, I can't remember. One of the charts, she's got all the top 10, hasn't she? It's no wonder, because she's just a perfection. She's just perfect at her craft. She's perfected her craft. That's what she's done. She doesn't do wrong anymore. She doesn't do anything wrong. Everything is perfect. It's insane. But yeah, this is, again, this was so meaningful, just on a personal level, in terms of, you know, her experiences and things. Obviously, I think there's an element of the female experience in there as well that's being discussed here, and the experience of being a female within this industry and things like that. It's all very meaningful stuff. It's all beautifully communicated by Taylor, and I just think she's just wonderful. She really is. This was fantastic. I am going to move on to Bejeweled, just because I want to get through the reaction things. I'm aware. How long is this one? This one quite long. No, I don't want either Etsy adverts. I don't want to buy anything from Etsy right now. Go away. Go away. Bejeweled. Oh, this is like 6 minutes. Are we going to get an active bit again? Like a one of those kind of active
scenes. Best work.
I'm going to assume yes. So this is Bejeweled. So this was released. How long was it? Was it like a couple of days after or something? I feel like there's a bit of a gap here, wasn't there? A few days after or something. It was the Billboard Top 100 that she took over the entire top 10 off. I can't remember which chart it was. Anyway, this is Bejeweled. This is Bejeweled. Let's do it!
This is her best work. That's disgusting.
Ooh.
No, I'm sorry, my dudes. He's going to choose me. I even my contoured dudes. My abs with the mud from the hot pen outside, so...
Cinderella situation.
I bought diamond nipple tassels, so...
Well, I'll be poisoning all the other maidens in the village.
Yes,
yes, mom, yes!
They're changing this year. So instead of just showing up at the ball looking hot, you have to enter a talent competition.
Oh.
And if you win, you get the keys to your own castle.
And a marriage proposal from the prince.
This is fantastic. I can't deal with it. Already, I cannot deal with this. Lady Alana. What's the D? Oh, this woman is a genius. House Wench Taylor wants the castle. Flip it out. Right.
Continue. Marriage proposal from the prince.
This is already fantastic. The music's not even starting.
I simply adore a proposal. The single most defining thing a lady could hope to achieve in her lifetime. The prize of all prizes. Look how many mommies received.
Well, we all know who's not coming tonight. That weasel down there cleaning up my sick from last night.
You must
grim.
Bedpot neck.
You honestly have to do this entire verbal abuse thing every time.
That song in the background.
Shut up, wench.
Stop it.
You smell.
Nobody cares.
Don't recognize that.
Speak not, tired, tacky wench. Clean. Ugh, ladies, worry not. Even if she were allowed to go, which she is not, the prince would never have anything to do with that little harlot again. He tired of her quite quickly, didn't he? Or should I say swiftly?
There it is. That joke never gets old. Thank you. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
That's a real, I'm Must sure that's got to be a real life statement.
You've been exiled.
She probably deals with that constantly.
You're not going anywhere anytime soon. Certainly not the ball.
We'll see about that, Mum.
Let's get many, many
children.
Bye.
Bye, snake.
Have
fun being exiled, stinky.
I'm gonna be hungover. I'm gonna drink your blood. I'm gonna be hungover.
Go on, Taylor. Get your ass to the ball.
Baby,
Didn't notice you walking all over my peace of mind. And the shoes I gave you, the voice is someone first, only works beautiful. When you're in that top five. And by the way, beautiful. Look at all the bejeweled, literally. Yes, you can. Yes! Oh, there's a woman. Oh, this is like Gatsby style lift. Look at her though, look at her. Oh. What? Taylor Swift, oh, Jesus. Like I'm falling over for you, literally. I've got a beanbag down here. I haven't mentioned it before, but I've got a beanbag and it's currently living right here. So when I stand up to move, I often trip over it, or fall on it, or whatever. The power of Taylor. Can we just give this woman, like, the keys to the world? Is that a thing? You know, they have, like, keys to the city. Do they have keys to the world? And if so, can we give them to Taylor, please? I feel like at this point, we might as well, you know, I mean, flipping it. If people like Donald Trump can be president, then surely Taylor Swift can be like goddess of the world or whatever. Goddess of Earth. That can be her official title. I'd be fine with that. I'd absolutely be fine with that. Please, can we make that happen? I don't know who we need to speak to, but I feel like it needs to happen. I would have no issue with that. And I don't think many people on Earth would, to be quite honest at this point. I think she's just that perfect. The way she looks here is just glorious. Again, just the lyrics to the song, everything about it. I've only caught so many of the lyrics. I try and, like, I can be very rubbish when it comes to... I should really have the lyrics up on screen. Maybe that's what I should have done, put the subtitles on. Because I do feel like I can be very rubbish at picking up lyrics because I'm focusing on everything else. It's hard to pick up the lyrics sometimes on, like, a first time watch, but when it comes to Taylor, I try and focus even more because I know obviously her lyrics are so meaningful and so good that I want to make sure I'm focusing on it. But based on what I have picked up, again, it's just so she's just a genius. She's a songwriting genius. Did she write these songs late at night? Is that what the details are? Because I know obviously there's the whole thing of sleepless nights and stuff. Did she write these songs during that time, during those periods? Is that what she's getting at here, or is it just about those periods? Let me know in the comments, because if she's writing this stuff in the middle of the night, which is like, I can't, like, yeah. Since the talent of this one off the charts.
Coca-Cola, vanilla flavor, zero sugar.
Nice. Oh my god. Again, it's got that very synthy electronic sound. Is that actually going back to that? Look at this outfit, mate. I can't. But the, What a woman. Oh, it's flipping Anita Von T's, right? Random. Look at the outfit. What a glorious, glittery Marilyn Monroe situation. Nice. I love these random, like, cameos she has in her music video. Again, like, again, this song is so gorgeous. I love that, like, in the background.
I would dance all night, and you can try to change my mind, but you might have to wait in line. What's a girl gonna do? The diamonds gotta shine.
Oh, I have been neglecting Taylor Swift, man. I need to get right back on this lady. All her content. But look at that, my God. What a star, man. Queen Pat. Prince Jack was forced to propose to him. Oh, it's flipping like Lady Antoinette. Not Lady, Marie Antoinette. She ghosted. No, wait, hang on. What's going on here? The ending to the story. I want to catch this. Queen Pat was impressed. Loving what Taylor did, obviously. Prince Jack was forced to propose to house wench Taylor. Forced to propose. Yeah, it's just like Marie Antoinette. That's so cool. There you go. Keys to the earth. Keys to the world. To the wings. She ghosted me. Oh, legend. Oh, I love her so much. I really do. Look at her. But kept the castle. Of course you did. Of course you do. Why wouldn't you? What a legend. That's how Cinderella should have ended, isn't it? Let's be honest. Oh, dragons! Mother of dragons! Is that Game of Thrones ref? She's got three dragons and everything. That's not a Mother of Dragons reference. I don't know what is. There's not much more, I think. No, Asda!
Sorry!
You can't see this. You won't be able to see this. It's an Asda advert. It says, have your elf a very Merry Christmas.
You must be here about the job. Nice costume.
And Will Ferrell's in it from Elf, which is actually pretty cool, but I still don't want it on my screen. There's not much more I feel like I can... anyone can say about this woman now. I feel like it's got to the point where she just is, like, you know, all the superlatives in the world, and I will continue to say them. I'll continue to say she's glorious. I'll continue to say she's a goddess. I'll continue to say she's perfect. But I feel like at this point, all of that's been said so many times by everyone that it's almost meaningless now. It doesn't mean anything anymore because she just is. She just is that. Everyone knows it. Everyone accepts it. She just is that. So you don't need to. You almost don't need to say it. You just sit back and appreciate what she does and go, "Yep, that's our Taylor," because she just will never fail to deliver. It's impossible for this woman to not deliver. I feel like and this is what happens to me when I go on a Taylor Swift when I check out one of her new albums or whatever. I just feel the need to go on a binge, and I feel like this is what's going to happen now. Taylor Swift is going to take over my life for the next, like, I don't even know how long. She's doing a tour, isn't she? You know the tour that she's doing, right? Has she announced world dates? Is she, like, because I know she's announced a bunch of, like, American dates and stuff. I'm assuming she's doing a world tour, but has she announced world dates yet? I feel like I should know this because I feel like someone let me know. If that's the case, then I apologise. But I need to see this woman live. Before I die, I need to see this woman live. I can't... It would be utterly, utterly wrong of me to go through my life without seeing Taylor Swift live once. At least once. At least once. Needs to happen. I'm just checking to see if there's any notable inclusions in terms of, like, writing or producing or anything like that within these two songs. I don't think there is. I think it's just Taylor Swift and Antonoff. Why am I forgetting his first name? Zach? Zach Antonov. Why am I forgetting that? That's stressing me out. It was mentioned earlier, wasn't it? In the lyrics. Jack Antonov, that's what. Why did I think Zach? Not in the lyrics, in the credits. Yeah, it was those two. What a woman. What a woman. I need to shut up because there's nothing, like I said, there's nothing I can say. The song was perfect. The music video was perfect. Everything that Taylor was delivering was perfect. Her voice was perfect. I love this kind of sound as well. I don't know if this is going to kind of be throughout the album. I've not really heard about what the album's like in terms of tone and style and stuff like that. Because obviously her last two albums, Evermore and Folklore, were very similar, really, in terms of like the style. It was very much this kind of folky sound, like leaning a bit more towards kind of early Taylor in a way, that kind of almost country sounding vibe and stuff with some of it, and like it was more that kind of stuff, very acoustic-y. And whereas, yeah, based on these two songs so far, she seems to be going in a different direction with this, which is really interesting. I really think this vibe kind of suits that idea of midnight and the idea of, you know, her thinking up this stuff and these thoughts going through her head when she's up late at night. It kind of suits that kind of synthy, kind of chilled out vibe that she's going for with this. Really suits that idea and the concept of this. So I'm really excited to hear what the album sounds like and if it follows that same direction. I imagine it will, because that tends to be the thing with Taylor, especially recently. She tends to just stick with a certain style and run with it throughout the album. There's a very clear through line within the album, within the recent albums and stuff. So I'm excited, hugely excited to check out this album. I will, like I say, I'm planning to record the first part of my album reaction straight after this, so hopefully it will be out very soon after this. If you're watching this reaction now, very soon after it's come out, either the album reaction is already out depending on when you're watching it, or it will be out soon. So watch out for that. And with that being said, I will leave it there. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Please, if you enjoy this reaction, drop us a like, drop us a comment, and of course subscribe to my lovely self. Join the royal family, become a royal yourself. That would be fantastic. And I'll see you next time, guys, for the next one. Salengay, I love you all. Goodbye.